فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. My beloved brothers and sisters, we are now on the fourth article of faith. So we spoke about al-Imanu billahi wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi, and we're now on the fourth one, which is wa rusulihi, the messengers. We're on the fourth article of faith from the six articles of faith. And we have how many more to go? We have two more to go, inshallah ta'ala, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. These six articles of faith, فَمَنْ لَمْ يَأْتِ بِهِ, the person who doesn't come with it, فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَكُونُ مُؤْمِنًا, he will never be a true believer. And he will never be a believer. So these six articles of faith are very important, my beloved brothers and sisters. So today, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to be speaking about al-Imanu bil-Rusul, believing in the messengers. The way, inshallah ta'ala, I plan to go into today's lesson is four steps. So four steps, inshallah ta'ala. The first one is al-Imanu bil-Rusul. What does it mean? Believing in the messengers, what does that mean? How do I believe in the messengers? So that's the one on the board right now, which you can all see. We'll take that one, inshallah ta'ala, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. The second, inshallah ta'ala, that we're going to be going through is nawaqidhul imani bil-rusul. What are the things that nullify your belief of the messengers? The second point that we're going to be taking is nawaqidh, the things that nullify one's belief of the messengers. Things that if you come with, it can nullify your iman of the messengers. The third, inshallah ta'ala, point that we're going to be speaking about is khasa'isul rusul. Distinct things for messengers. Distinct things and unique things for the messengers. And the fourth, which is the last one, inshallah ta'ala, is going to be khasa'isul nabi. Things that are distinct for the prophets. Prophets. So the first, the third one was messengers. And the fourth one is prophets. So distinct things and unique things for messengers. And the fourth one is distinct and unique things for prophets, inshallah ta'ala. So those are the four things that we're going to be going through, inshallah ta'ala, today in our series of what it means to believe in the messengers. To believe in the messengers. So inshallah ta'ala, here we have al-Iman al-Mujmal. So believing in the messengers is two things, inshallah ta'ala. The first is al-Iman al-Mujmal, and we're very common with this word. We're used to this word now, al-Mujmal, what it means. It's a generic and a comprehensive belief. Al-Iman al-Mujmal. And the second one is al-Iman al-Mufassal, detailed belief. Al-Iman al-Mufassal. It's a detailed form of a belief that every single one of us has to come with. But before we go into al-Iman al-Mujmal, or we go into al-Iman al-Mufassal, what does it mean to believe in the messengers? Okay? What does it mean actually? What's the definition of it? And so every time when we put something in the middle, it means that's the definition of the title. It's the definition of the title. So it is messengers. Who are they and what do they mean? So we know what al-Iman means because we've been taking that word very often. Al-Iman, what it means, we know that. But what does it mean, bil-rusuli, messengers? And who are messengers? So the definition is right here for you, and it is هو من أوحي إليهم. They are those who have been sent revelation on them. They are those who have هم من أوحي إليهم شرع لتبليغه. من أوحي إليهم شرع لتبليغه, to convey it. So they've been sent a revelation on them, and they've been instructed and they've been commanded to convey this message. That's what they've been told. لتبليغه, to convey it. شرع لتبليغه, to convey that message. To convey that message which they have been told and that has been sent on them. So that's what a messenger means. So if one asks you what's the definition of a messenger, you say, من أوحي إليهم شرع. Anyone who a sharia, a legislation has been revealed unto him, and he's been commanded and he's been told to convey it. That's what a messenger means. Okay? So now that we've understood what a messenger is, we now want to go into, inshallah ta'ala, the first type of believing in the messengers. كَيْفِيَةُ الْإِيمَانِ بِالرُّسُولِ الْإِيمَانُ الْمُجْمَلِ. What does الْإِيمَانُ الْمُجْمَلِ means? And again, إِيمَانُ الْمُجْمَلِ is the amount, it's the level مَنْ لَمْ يَأْتِ بِهِ Whoever doesn't come with this amount, لَا يَكُونُ مُؤْمِنًا بِالرُّسُلِ You're not one who believes in the messengers. Just like, remember when we were talking about the other previous articles of faith, this amount, which is always on the right side, it's always going to be on the right side, okay? It's an iman al-mujmal, it's an amount, it's a qadr, an amount. If you don't come with this amount, then that means this article of faith is absent from you, it's missing. And if it's missing from you, that means you're not a believer. So al-iman al-mujmal, it's an amount, it's a quantity that you have to come with. And if you don't come with it, then you are not a believer of the messengers. You're not a believer of the messengers. The evidence for that is that we have to believe in the messengers, or we have to believe in all messengers. Al-imanu bi kulli rasulin, it is to believe in every messenger, or nabi, or prophet. We believe in every. Al-imanu is to believe bi kulli rasulin, every messenger, wa nabiyin, and every prophet. That's what it means. That you believe in every messenger and you believe in every single prophet. Okay? What's the evidence for that? The evidence for that is the verse in Surah An-Nisa, Ayah 152. Allah says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ Those who believe in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, and they believe in the messengers of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, وَلَمْ يُفَرِّقُوا بَيْنَ أَحَدٍ مِّنْهُمْ And they do not divide, they do not distinguish one from the other. أُولَٰئِكَ يُؤْتِيهِمْ أُجُورَهُمْ Those are the ones who Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is going to give them their reward. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا Verily Allah is one who is merciful and is one who is forgiving, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now observe this ayah. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he say? وَلَمْ يُفَرِّقُوا بَيْنَ أَحَدٍ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا Allah says in the verse, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ If you look at the verse here, Allah says, وَالَّذِينَ those آمَنُوا who believe in Allah, وَرُسُلِهِ and they believe in His messengers. Let's observe وَرُسُلِهِ. The rusul here has come plural. The verse, if you go back to the verse, the word rusul is plural. Okay, it's plural. It's a jam'a, it's a plural. And the qa'ida is that وَالْجَمْعُ الْمُضَافِ يُفِيدُ الْعُمُومِ If a word comes plural, and then it's attributed, because look, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ The ones who believe in Allah, وَرُسُلِهِ And His messengers, Allah's messengers. So the messengers are being attributed to Allah. And the word rusul here is plural. So if a plural is attributed, the qa'ida, the principle according to the scholars, is that it shows generalization. And so why do we want this to come out of it? Why are we pointing this out? The reason why we're pointing out this is because آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ They believed in Allah وَجَمِيعُ And they believed in all of Allah's messengers. That's the meaning that we want it to come out. That they didn't just believe in Muhammad or Isa ibn Maryam or Musa, but rather they believed in all of the messengers. And that's the amount that we said, if you don't come with, then you're a disbeliever. That you say to yourself, every messenger and every prophet that Allah has sent down, subhanahu wa ta'ala, I believe them. Based on this ayah, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُولِهِ وَلَمْ يُفَرِّقُوا بَيْنَ أَحَدٍ مِّنْهُمْ أُولَٰئِكَ يُؤْتِيهِمْ أُجُورَهُمْ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا That's the first part, which is al-imanu al-mujmal, the generic, the comprehensive belief of the messengers. We're now, inshallah ta'ala, going to move on al-imanu al-mufassal. Al-imanu al-mufassal. Al-imanu al-mufassal means the detailed belief of the messengers. It's not just generic, it can't be comprehensive. Now it's actually more in details. It's more in details. And what does it mean? As you can see, inshallah ta'ala, on the board, I have, inshallah ta'ala, 3 points that I've written on the board. The first one is, so we know what it means, al-iman al-mufassal. Al-iman al-mufassal, it means that the person goes further and takes a step further in believing in the messengers. You can't just have that generic belief. It means that you have more details. The first one is that you believe in al-imanu believing in bi asma'ihim their names. So it means that you believe al-imanu bi asma'ihim. You believe in their names. As we know, Allah has mentioned the messengers in the Quran, which Allah has mentioned, how much in number? 25 names Allah has mentioned in the Quran. If you go in the Quran and you look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned 25 names of messengers in the Quran. As for prophets, لَمْ يَأْتِ عَدَدُهُمْ, their amount and how much they are in number has not come to us. And no one knows their numbers, how much they are in number, إِلَّا اللَّهِ, except Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And there's no textual evidence which we have that authentically is transmitted from the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam that states to us how much they are in number, prophets. As for messengers, we have a textual evidence that states to us how much they are in number. And the authentic hadith mentions that they are 315. So they are 315 in number, messengers. How much has been told to us? 25 of them have been told to us. But we do not know, we don't know at all, how much number of prophets there are. We don't know that. That's a number and an amount we don't have no knowledge of. You see? But the messengers, we have an amount. We have a figure that has come from the messenger alayhi salatu wasalam that their amount is 315. But those whose names we know, and we know their names, and that the Quran has stated are only 25 of them. And those 25, we believe them based on their names. So we believe there's a prophet called Ibrahim, Nabiullah Ismail, Ishaq, Yaqub, Dawood, Sulaiman. We believe those names. They're mentioned in the Quran, we believe them. And they're 25 in number. So that's a Iman al-Mufassal, a detailed belief. Al-Iman bi-Asma'in, believe in their names. The second one is Al-Iman, believing in bihim, them, wa-tiba'u. The second one is Al-Iqraru bihim. It means Al-Iqraru bihim. Al-Iqraru bihim is that you actually are, you have in your heart an unwavering conviction of belief in them. You have an unwavering conviction of belief in them. But this is specific to who? Al-Iqraru bihim is specific to who? The prophets and the messengers. And our Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. Al-Iqraru bihim is that you believe in him, unwavering conviction in your heart towards them. But the ittiba' following is specific to our Prophet. Tiba' is specific to our Prophet. Because the previous legislations, Nusikh al-Shara'i', the previous legislations, all of them have been abrogated. They have been abrogated. That's why the Prophet ﷺ, he said, لو كان موسى حيا, if Nabiullah Musa was alive, ما وسعه إلا اتباعي, nothing else would be open for him, and no other path would be a path which he would take except to follow me. Nabiullah Musa, if he was alive today, the Prophet said, there would be no other path which he would take, and there would be no other path open for him except to follow me as a Prophet. So Nabiullah Muhammad abrogated all previous prophets. All previous prophets, we believe in them. We believe that they came with the legislations. We believe they are prophets who obeyed their Lord. We believe the stories of theirs that are mentioned in the Quran. We believe all of that. But following is specific and unique for our messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Ittiba', following is unique for our prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The third thing is, so that was the second. The third, which is the last, is believing بِكُلِّ رَسُولٍ, that every prophet بَلَّغَ مَا أُرْسِلَ إِلَيْهِ, every prophet conveyed everything that was sent to him. Isa ibn Maryam, Nabiullah Isa ibn Maryam, every single thing which Allah sent unto him, he conveyed it. He never hid it. Ibrahim alayhi salam, Sulaiman, Dawood, Nabiullah Muhammad, all prophets we believe, they fulfilled their responsibility. They done their job. They conveyed their message. And they did as they were commanded to do so. That's another belief we have of them. That every single prophet, every single messenger, he conveyed everything which he was told to convey. And everything he was told to tell his people and command them and to prohibit them from, every prophet and every messenger, they did as they were commanded. That's what it means at Iman al-Mufassal. So now, inshallah ta'ala, if somebody asks you and says to you, how does one believe in a messenger? What does it mean to believe in a messenger or a prophet? Today, you know. It's two. Al-Iman al-Mujmal And that means to believe in بِكُلِّ رَسُولٍ وَنَبِيٍ. It means that you believe in all prophets and all messengers. And this is in a very generic amount, a generic manner. And I said, if you don't come with this amount, you're not a believer of the messengers. And you're a person who hasn't come with this article of faith. Also, الإيمان المفصل, which is a detailed belief of the messengers. الإيمان بأسمائهم, you believe in their names. الإقرار بهم والتباع, that you have unwavering conviction regarding them. You believe in everything about them. And you follow our messenger, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Last but not least is that, ما جاء به نبينا. You believe in every single prophet what they have come with, and you also believe in everything our messenger Muhammad ibn Abdullah came with. Everything he which he came with, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Everything that he told us, alayhi salatu wa sallam. And everything which he informed us of, whether what happened, what's happening, and what's going to happen, that he has told us, alayhi salatu wa sallam, we believe in it. Whether we see it, or whether we don't, it doesn't matter to us. We believe it. We believe it. Now, I've answered and I've done my first point, which is kayfiyatul iman bil rusul. How can I believe in the messengers? We're now, inshallah ta'ala, going into the second, which is nawaqidul iman bil rusul. Nawaqidul iman bil rusul. What are the things that nullify belief of the messengers? And as you can see, I've written 5 points that if a person comes with, it will nullify their belief. It will nullify their belief of the messengers. The first one is الإيمان ببعضهم دون بعض. The first one is الإيمان ببعضهم يعني بعض الرسل, is to believe in some of the messengers دون بعض, not the others. So you say, I'm only going to believe this messenger, I'm not going to believe in this other one or this one or this one. I'm only going to pick, you pick and choose who you want to believe from the messengers. This is disbelief, and it nullifies your belief of the messengers. The first one is الإيمان believing in ببعض الرسل دون بعض, believing in some of the messengers and not the others. And this goes against the verse of Allah تبارك وتعالى in Surah An-Nisa, Ayah 150 to Ayah 151. Surah An-Nisa, Ayah 150 to 151. Allah says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَكْفُرُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ وَيُرِيدُونَ أَن يُفَرِّقُوا بَيْنَ اللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ وَيُرِيدُونَ وَيَقُولُونَ نؤمن ببعض ونكفر ببعض ويريدون أن يتخذوا بين ذلك سبيلا أولئك هم الكافرون حقا وأعتدنا للكافرين عذابا مهينا. So in this verse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, إن الذين يكفرون بالله ورسله, those who disbelieve in Allah and the messengers. إن الذين يكفرون بالله ورسله, they disbelieve in Allah and the messengers. ويريدون أن يفرقوا بين الله ورسله, and they want to divide between Allah and his messengers. They want to divide between them. وَيُرِيدُونَ أَن يُفَرِّقُوا بَيْنَ اللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ وَيَقُولُونَ, and they say to you and they respond to you, نُؤْمِنُ بِبَعْضٍ وَنَكْفُرُ بِبَعْضٍ, we believe in some and we disbelieve in some. وَيُرِيدُونَ أَن يَتَّخِذُوا بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ سَبِيلًا, and that's the path they want to tread on, that's the path they want to be upon. Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ حَقًّا, those are the true disbelievers. وَعَتَدْنَا لِلْكَافِرِينَ عَذَابًا مُهِينًا, and Allah says, we have prepared for the disbelievers a severe punishment. So this ayah clearly shows us that these people are أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ حَقًّا, they're true disbelievers. They are true disbelievers. So saying that I believe in some prophets and messengers and I don't believe in the rest is disbelief of Allah and his messengers. It's actually disbelief of all of them. The second thing that nullifies a person's belief of the messengers is التحاكم لغير الرسل. أما التحاكم لغير الرسول إعراضا أو إباء أو شكا. This is the second one. التحاكم, to go to judgment and to look for a judge, a ruling. From what? لغير الرسول. Here we said الرسول, meaning our Prophet Muhammad, the messenger, the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. So you're trying to look for a حكم, ruling, from anyone other than the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you do, and you do it out of i'rad, you're turning away from it internally and externally. Or iba'an, or you do it out of arrogance. Or shakkan, or you do it out of doubt, that you doubt the Prophet's hukum, then this is disbelief as well. It's naqid. It nullifies your iman bil rusul. It nullifies your belief of the messengers. You're not a believer of it. And this is قوله تعالى, the speech of Allah تبارك وتعالى in Surah Tawbah, Ayah 47, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَيَقُولُونَ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ. They say that we believe in Allah, وَبِالرَّسُولِ, and we believe in the messenger, وَأَطَعْنَا, and we believe in, ثُمَّ يَتَوَلَّى فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ, and then a group of them, they turn away, ثُمَّ يَتَوَلَّى فَرِيقٌ, a group of them, منهم, from amongst them, turn away, مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ, after what they have claimed, and after what they have said, they turn away. Allah then says, وَمَا أُولَٰئِكَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Those are not believers. وَيَقُولُونَ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ. They say to you, I believe in Allah. وَيَقُولُونَ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالرَّسُولِ وَأَطَعْنَا ثُمَّ يَتَوَلَّى فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ وَمَا أُولَٰئِكَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ. وَمَا أُولَٰئِكَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Those are not believers. They're disbelievers. They're kuffar. Because they turned away. ثُمَّ يَتَوَلَّى. They turn away from Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala's messenger's path. After they've claimed that they believe in Allah, they believe in the messenger, salawatullahi wa salamun alayhi, and that they obey Allah and His messenger. And then they turn away. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this ayah, those people, وَمَا أُولَٰئِكَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Those are not believers. The reason why they're not believers is because the article of faith, which is al-imanu bil-rusul, is missing from them. Al-imanu bil-rusul is missing from them. They've come with a nullifier that nullifies their belief of the messengers, or the belief of the messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The third thing that is a nullifier of the person's belief of the messengers, نواقض الإيمان بالرسول, the third thing that will nullify your belief of the messengers is that اعتقاد, to believe أن الرسول, that you believe the messengers and والأنبياء and the prophets لهم شيء من خصائص الربوبية أو الألوهية, that you believe they have اعتقاد لهم, to believe for them شيئا من خصائص الربوبية أو الألوهية, you believe they have rights in Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala's rububiyyah and uluhiyyah. You are giving them khasa'is rububiyyah. This is khas, this is specific for Allah, rububiyyah specific for Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're giving it to them. Or uluhiyyah, which is the rights of Allah, and we already spoke about that. We spoke about what rububiyyah means, and we spoke about what uluhiyyah means. You're trying to give the rububiyyah that we spoke about, and the uluhiyyah that we spoke about, you're trying to give it to the prophets or the messengers. This is also disbelief. And Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He mentions that in the Quran. Surah Al-Ma'idah, ayah 17. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمَ. Look what Allah says. لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ. They are disbelievers. Who are the disbelievers? الَّذِينَ قَالُوا, the ones who said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ, that Allah is Isa ibn Maryam. That Masih, Isa ibn Maryam, is Allah. لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَ. Allah says, لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمَ. Allah says, لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمَ. Anyone who says that Masih, يعني عيسى بن مريم, is Allah, Allah says, they're disbelievers. They are truly, indeed disbelievers. قُلْ فَمَنْ يَمْلِكُ, who is the one who controls? Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala is saying, قُلْ فَمَنْ يَمْلِكُ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْئًا, who is the one who has control? إِنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يُهْلِكَ الْمَسِيحَ. If Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala chooses to destroy Isa ibn Maryam and brings death to him and makes Isa ibn Maryam die, وَأُمَّهُ and his mother, Allah brings death to them, وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا, and Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala destroys everything on the face of this earth, all of them, He destroys it, who is the one who controls everything then? If Isa ibn Maryam dies and he goes and Allah destroys him, and Allah destroys Maryam bint Imran, and Allah destroys everyone on the face of this earth, who is the one who's running the world then? Who is the one who's controlling the world and who's running everything? So this ayah clearly mentions, لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا, the ones who said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمُ, is kuffar, they are disbelievers. Also in another verse, Allah says, لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ ثَالِثُ ثَلَاثَ وَمَا مِنْ إِلَهٍ إِلَّا إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ وَإِنْ لَمْ يَنْتَوْا عَمَّا يَقُولُونَ لَيَمَسَّنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. Also Allah تبارك وتعالى also says in another ayah, ما المسيح ابن مريم إلا رسول قد خلت من قبله الرسل وأمه صديقة كانا يأكلان الطعام انظر كيف نبين لكم الآيات ثم انظر أنا يؤفكون. So this is something that's تحصيل الحاصل. It's known out of necessity that Isa ibn Maryam and his mother are eating food. They eat. How can they be prophets and messengers? Sorry, how could they be, and how can it be given to them khasa'is al-rububiyyah and uluhiyyah? They go and they eat and they drink. Allah does not eat, nor does he drink. ولذلك Allah says in the ayah, in another ayah, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ. Allah says, we have not sent down before you, Muhammad. مِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. Every messenger that we sent before you, إِلَّا إِنَّهُمْ لَيَأْكُلُونَ الطَّعَامَ. Except, إِنَّهُم لَيَأْكُلُونَ الطَّعَامَ. Except they eat food. وَيَمْشُونَ فِي الْأَسْوَاقِ. And they walk in the markets. So the meaning for this is that their situation was like this. Every messenger and every prophet's situation was that he ate and he drank. And since he eats and he drinks, this is, he can't have rububiyyah and uluhiyyah. It can't be a characteristic of his. So we mentioned that. Also in the last ayah in Surah Al-Kahf, what does Allah say? إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. I'm just a human like you guys. إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. يُوحَى إِلَيَّ أَنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ. إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ. I'm just a human. So the ayat that I mentioned, لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ ابْنُ مَرْيَمَ. قُلْ فَمَنْ يَمْلِكُ لَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْءٍ إِنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يُهْلِكَ الْمَسِيحَ ابْنَ مَرْيَمَ وَأُمُّهُ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا. And قوله تعالى, the statement of Allah تبارك وتعالى, where he says, مَا الْمَسِيحُ ابْنُ مَرْيَمَ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ وَأُمُّهُ صِدِّيقَةٌ كَانَ يَأْكُلَانِ الطَّعَامَ انظُرْ كَيْفَ نُبَيِّنُ لَكُمُ الْآيَاتِ ثُمَّ انظُرْ أَنَّى يُؤْفَكُونَ, which is Surah Al-Ma'idah, ayah 75. And the statement of Allah تبارك وتعالى, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ إِلَّا إِنَّهُمْ لَيَأْكُلُونَ الطَّعَامَ وَيَمْشُونَ فِي الْأَسْوَاقِ. All those verses show that this belief of saying that we're going to give a prophet characteristics of Allah, خصائص الربوبية, the distinct rights of Allah, which is ربوبية, الألوهية, to a messenger or a prophet, it is ناقض, it nullifies your belief of the messengers. The fourth one, which is, اعتقاد to believe أنهم يعلمون الغيب المطلق. The fourth one, and that is ناقض الرابع. It's the fourth one, is to believe, اعتقاد to believe أنهم يعلمون الغيب المطلق. That you believe that they know the الغيب المطلق, the unrestricted غيب. The prophets do know part الغيب المقيد. They have an amount of unseen things that they've been informed about. Because Allah تبارك وتعالى, He says, in the ayah, in Surah Al-Jinn, what does he say? إِلَّا مَنِ ارْتَضَى مِنْ رَسُولٍ فَإِنَّهُ يَسْلُكُ مِنْ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهُ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِ رَسَدًا. إِلَّا مَنِ ارْتَضَى مِنْ رَسُولٍ. Allah's ghaib, He doesn't give it to everybody. إِلَّا مَنِ ارْتَضَى مِنْ رَسُولٍ. Except a prophet who He's pleased with. He gives him ilm al-ghaib, like in muqayyad, restricted. Not everything. Because there are ayats that show that prophets don't have the unrestricted ilm al-ghaib. مثلا قوله تعالى, say to them, قُلْ لَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ الْأَرْضِ الْغَيْبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Say to them, Muhammad, Allah is saying to this, لَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ. No one knows what's in the السَّمَاوَاتِ. وَالْأَرْضِ, and anything on this earth. No one knows it. وَالْأَرْضِ الْغَيْبَ, the unseen, إِلَّا اللَّهِ, except Allah. وَمَا يَشْعُرُونَ أَيَّانَ يُبْعَثُونَ. Also Allah تبارك وتعالى says in another ayah, قل سيد محمد لا أملك لنفسي نفعا ولا ضرا إلا ما شاء الله ولو كنت أعلم الغيب لاستكثرت من الخير وما مسني السوء. قل سيد محمد لا أملك لنفسي, I can't even bring to my own self نفعا good ولا ضرا and harm, I can't. The Prophet says عليه الصلاة والسلام, إلا ما شاء الله, except that which Allah wills. ولو كنت أعلم الغيب, and if I knew the unseen, لاستكثرت من الخير, I would have increased in good. وما مسني السوء, harm would not have touched me. So to reconcile between these verses, it means that prophets only know what Allah wants to tell them, and they do not know الغيب المطلق. They don't know the unrestricted غيب. They only know what Allah has told them, سبحانه وتعالى. They don't know that. And anybody who does say that the prophets and the messengers know unrestricted knowledge of the unseen, then this person has come with ناقض من نواقض الإيمان بالرسول. You're actually nullifying your article of faith of believing in the messengers. They only know what Allah has told them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's restricted. It's not everything. It's restricted. It's restricted because this verse shows you that it's restricted. قُلْ لَوْ كُنْتُ أَعْلَمُ الْغَيْبَ. If I knew the unseen. What ghaib is he talking about? He's saying that I know something. I know what Allah has told me. But that's restricted. But I don't know everything. I don't know the everything. No, I don't. Last but not least, which is the fifth one, and that is the last one, and that is تنقص الرسل, belittling and putting messengers down, والاستخفاف بهم, to belittle them and to put them down, or sabbihim, or to even insult them and call them names. فَمَنْ سَبَّ الرُّسُولَ, anyone who insults a messenger, or he belittles that messenger and puts that messenger down, فَإِنَّهُ قَدْ أَتَى, that individual has come with بِنَاقِضٍ مِنْ نَوَاقِضِ الْإِمَانِ بِالرُّسُولِ. You have come with a nullifier, from the things that nullify your belief of the messengers. You've come with a naqid now. You've nullified your belief of the messengers. The article of faith of believing in the messengers is gone now. And because this goes against قوله تعالى سورة الأحزاب آية 57, Allah تبارك وتعالى, he says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُؤْذُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ لَعَنَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ وَعَدَّ لَهُمْ عَذَابًا مُهِينًا. Allah says in the ayah, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُؤْذُونَ اللَّهَ, anyone who harms Allah, وَرُسُلَهُ, and the messengers of Allah, لَعَنَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا, Allah curses him in this world. And la'an means أَطَرْضُ مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ, Allah distances mercy from them. فِي الدُّنْيَا, in this world, and وَالْآخِرَةِ, and the day of judgment. And for them is what? وَعَدَّ لَهُمْ عَذَابًا مُهِينًا, and Allah has prepared for them a severe punishment, the day of judgment. So وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْذُونَ اللَّهَ, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُؤْذُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ لَعَنَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ وَلَهُمْ وَعَدَّ لَهُمْ عَذَابًا مُهِينًا, and Allah has prepared a severe punishment for them. So what we need to all know, that my beloved brothers and sisters, is that when we come with al-Iman bil Rusul, we should stay away from the things that will nullify it. Many Muslims say to you, I believe in the messengers. Wallahi, I do. But then you see that they fall short in this one, for instance. You see, they fall short in this one. They actually give the Prophet unrestricted knowledge of the unseen. And that's wrong. That's wrong. Or for example, they give him khasa'is al-rububiyya or uluhiyya to the Prophet. They give him khasa'is al-rububiyya or uluhiyya. This should be something you should focus on, my beloved brothers and sisters. And you don't want to go against these overwhelming evidences. I'm just giving you some of them. I'm just giving you some. There are many more other evidences to prove each point. Now we're going to go into the third point. Inshallah ta'ala, we spoke about kayfiyatul imanu bil rusul, what it means to believe in the messengers. We also spoke about nawaqid al-imanu bil rusul, what is it that nullifies your belief of the messengers. We're now going to go speak about, inshallah ta'ala, khasa'isul rusul, unique things that messengers have. The first thing is al-wahyu, revelation. Allah sends revelation to them. And the way Allah sends revelation to them is عن طريق جبريل, through Jibreel. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in Surah Al-Kahf, ayah 110, قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ يُوحَى إِلَيَّ أَنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهُ وَاحِدٌ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ يُوحَى إِلَيَّ. Revelation is sent to me. So this verse, clearly the Prophet is saying, alayhi salatu wasalam, I am a human being just like you, but the distinct thing I have over you that you wouldn't have is that revelation is sent to me. So this is khasa'is, a distinct thing, a unique characteristics, a unique attribute that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has given to messengers, which is revelations are sent on them. Khasa'is al-rusul is al-wahyu, revelation. And the evidence I gave you is the ayah in Surah Al-Kahf, ayah 110. The second is al-usmah, they are infallible. They are infallible. In that which they convey, فِيمَا يُبَلِّغُونَهُ عَنِ اللَّهِ, they are infallible in that which they convey from Allah تبارك وتعالى. So it's impossible that they fall in a shortcoming and a mistake in that which they convey from Allah تبارك وتعالى. They will never fall short and do a mistake in that which they convey. So whatever they convey from Allah تبارك وتعالى, it's from Allah. And that's why Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, مَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ مَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهِ مَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهِ. Anyone who obeys the messengers, anyone who obeys the messenger has obeyed Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Because the reason why obeying the messenger means by default that you've obeyed Allah is because that the messenger, whatever he is telling you and he's commanding you, is 100% from Allah. 100% from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's no mistake in it. There's no shortcoming in it. There's no error or mistake in it. So that's why it's Allah tabarak wa ta'ala saying that you've obeyed me by following the messengers. Because all they are speaking and they're doing is what I've told them and commanded them to do. So they're infallible from that. And they won't do mistakes in that. Okay? The third, inshallah ta'ala, is تَنَامُ أَعْيُنُهُمْ وَلَا تَنَامُ قُلُوبُهُمْ. Their eyes go to sleep. So they do sleep from their eyes. تَنَامَ عَيْنُهُمْ. Their eyes is closed and then you go sleep like that. But وَلَا تَنَامُوا قُلُوبُهُمْ. Their hearts don't go to sleep. They're actually awake. And this is based on the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam that Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim both narrated in their Sahih that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, يَا عَائِشَ أَوْ عَائِشَ إِنَّ عَيْنِي تَنَامَانِي. My eyes, both of them, they go to sleep. وَلَا يَنَامُ قَلْبِي. But my heart doesn't go to sleep. My heart is awake. Also in another hadith, Imam al-Bukhari narrated this one that the Prophet said, وَكَذَلِكَ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ. And also the same is for the Prophets. أَعْيُنُهُمْ تَنَامُ أَعْيُنُهُمْ. Their eyes go to sleep. وَلَا تَنَامُ قُلُوبُهُمْ. But their hearts don't go to sleep. So even Prophets and Messengers are like that. Okay? So eyes of theirs is sleeping, but their hearts is awake. Their hearts are awake, but their eyes go to sleep. The fourth distinct characteristics is لا تأكل الأرض. The earth does not eat أجسادهم, their bodies. The earth does not eat their body and their flesh. It doesn't. ولذلك the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said إن الله حرم على الأرض أن تأكل أجساد الأنبياء. Allah تبارك وتعالى he prohibited the earth to eat from the flesh and the bodies of the prophets. And Imam Abu Dawood narrated it. So it is impossible, okay? And it can't happen. And تأكل الأرض, that the earth eats the flesh and the body of the prophets. So they are as they die. When the day they died till now, they're still the same in their graves. Okay? Also another thing that falls here is that يُدْفَنُونَ حَيْثُ يَمُوتُونَ. They are buried where they die. Prophets are buried where they die. So messengers, when they die somewhere, they don't get moved from where they died. They're not taken nowhere else. They are actually buried exactly where they died. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "ما قبض الله نبيا إلا في موطن الذي يحب أن يدفن فيه." That Allah تبارك وتعالى does not take the soul of a prophet. Allah doesn't, except in the place which that prophet loves for him to be buried in. So the place that the prophet loves to be buried in is where Allah takes his nafs from him, so he can be buried there. Al-Imam Abu Dawood rahimahullah narrated that. Imam Tirmidhi narrated that. وَلِذَلِكَ the Prophet صَلَوَاتُ اللَّهِ وَسَلَامُ عَلَيْهِ our Prophet, when he died in the house of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, may Allah be pleased with her, he was buried there. He was not removed and he was not taken nowhere else. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was buried exactly where he died. Okay? He wasn't taken to Baqir, the place where he used to visit. Rather, he died in the house of Aisha and he was buried there. And he was the one who chose to be in Aisha's house. He told his other wives if they can allow him and give him the permission to stay in the house of Aisha. And that's where he loved alayhi salatu wasalam to stay. And so he stayed there alayhi salatu wasalam, and he died there and he was buried there. Alayhi salatu wasalam. The last one, which is the fifth one, is that ahya, they are alive fi quburihim, in their graves, yusalloon, praying. So they are in their graves. They are in their graves, ahya, fi quburihim, in their graves, yusallun. Abu Ya'la narrated this. But the life that they have in their graves is not hayatu dunyawi. It's not the life that we're aware of. It's not this kind of life. It's hayatun barzakhiyah. So it's two different lives. So you can't compare it to this life. Okay, it's different. It's two different worlds that we're in. They are in the life of the barzakh, and we're in the life of this dunya. So that's why some people whose hearts are ill and they're sick-hearted, they would say to you, you can't ask a prophet for something because he's alive. You will say to him, yes, he's alive, lakin hayatun barzakhi. And I'm alive, hayatun dunyawi. So our two worlds don't meet. When I'm asking from somebody, they have to live the life of which I am living in, which is hayatun dunyawi. The hayatun dunyawi. Hayatun barzakhi is another life. It's another life in which the prophets are living. And then evidences have clearly stated that, and we believe that. Huh? We believe that. So those are five things, and I'll go over it one more time. The first one is al-wahy, revelation. And we mentioned the ayah, قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ يُوحَى إِلَيَّ أَنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهُ وَاحِدٌ. Al-ismah, infallible. مَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهِ. Anyone who obeys the messengers has obeyed Allah. So they're infallible. The hadith here, تَنَامُ أَعْيُنُهُمْ, their eyes go to sleep. وَلَا تَنَامُ قُلُوبُهُمْ, but their hearts don't go to sleep, is based on the hadith of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, where the Prophet said to her in Sahih al-Bukhari and Muslim. The hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim, that the Prophet sallallahu wasallam alayhi said to Aisha, يا عائشة تنام عيناي my two eyes go to sleep, وَلَا تَنَامُ قَلْبِي, but my heart doesn't go to sleep. And also that the Prophet said, الأنبياء, the Prophets, تَنَامُ أَعْيُنُهُمْ, their eyes go to sleep, وَلَا تَنَامُ قُلُوبُهُمْ, but not their hearts. That's in Bukhari. The fourth one is, لَا تَأْكُلُ الْأَرْضَ أَجْسَادُهُمْ, that the earth does not eat their flesh. And we mentioned the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, مَا قَيَّضَ اللَّهُ نَبِيًّا, Allah did not take the life of a prophet on this earth except the place which he loves. The place which he loves, his nafs is taken, in which he loves to be buried, and he's buried at that particular place. And the fifth, which is the last one, أَحْيَاءٌ فِي قُبُورِهِمْ, that they are alive in their graves. We mentioned the hadith of Abu Ya'la, where the Prophet said, الْأَنْبِيَاءَ أَحْيَاءٌ فِي قُبُورِهِمْ يُصَلُّونَ, that the Prophets are alive in their graves praying. Those are five distinct and unique characteristics which they have. None of us have this. None of us here have any of that. These are unique things for them. Alayhim as-salam. Last, inshallah ta'ala, but not least, our last point, which is Qasa'isun Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that is the distinct characteristics and the distinct attributes that our Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam has. This is something unique for him over all of the previous messengers. These are not all of them, but we've only chosen some of them, inshallah ta'ala. This is only some. The first one is Afdalul Anbiya. He's the best of all prophets. He's the greatest of them all, alayhi salatu wasalam. And there's no prophet, فَلَيْسَ هُنَاكَ نَبِيٌّ أَفْضَلَ مِن نَبِيِّنَا, there's no prophet greater and more higher than our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam. And we believe that prophets are not all of one level. As Allah said, تِلْكَ الرُّسُلُ فَضَّلْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ, The messengers, Allah has given them virtue one over the other. This is in Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 253. What's the evidence that he's the best of them all? The evidence for that is when he said, أَنَا سَيِّدُ وَلَدِ آدَمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, I am the master of the children of Adam, the day of judgment. You see, فَهُوَ سَيِّدُهُمْ, he's going to be their master. All of them, they're behind him. عَلَيْهِ صَلَاتُ وَالسَّلَامُ. And he is the most beloved creation to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Wa ahabbuhum ilayhi. The most beloved one to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. So that's the first one. Afdalul anbiya. The best of prophets is our prophet. That's the first distinct characteristics of his. The second one is bu'itha ila thaqalaini. Bu'itha ila thaqalaini. And that means he was sent to the jinn and he was sent to the ins. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَةً لِلنَّاسِ بَشِيرًا وَنَذِيرًا وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Allah says in this particular verse, we have not sent you except كَافَةً to all of mankind. So this evidence is that all mankind, whatever ethnicity, whatever country you're from, whatever background you're from, human beings, all of them, Allah has sent Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a messenger and a prophet to them. So that's the evidence for all of humans, all of mankind. As for the jinn, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, وَإِذْ صَرَفْنَا إِلَيْكَ نَفَرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقُرْآنَ فَلَمَّا حَذَرُوهُ قَالُوا أَنْصِتُوا فَلَمَّا قُضِيَ وَلَّوْا إِلَى قَوْمِهِمْ مُنذِرِينَ قَالُوا يَا قَوْمَنَا إِنَّا سَمِعْنَا كِتَابًا أُنْزِلَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مُوسَى مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْحَقِّ وَإِلَى طَرِيقٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ يَا قَوْمَنَا أَجِيبُوا دَاعِيَ اللَّهِ وَآمِنُوا بِهِ يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ مِنْ ذُنُوبِكُمْ وَيُجِرْكُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ وَمَنْ لَا يُجِيبُ دَاعِيَ اللَّهِ فَلَيْسَ بِمُؤْمِنٍ فليس بمعجز في الأرض وليس له من دونه أولياء أولئك في ضلال مبين. So this verse clearly instructs and shows us that what? That the Prophet صلى الله عليه was sent to these jinns. This is Surah Al-Ahqaf, ayah 29-32. That he was sent to them. That the jinns. And that's why the jinns are giving da'wah to the other jinns. And what they're saying to the other jinns and what they're telling them, قالوا يا قومنا إنا سمعنا كتابا أنزل من بعد موسى. We have a prophet who has come after Nabiullah Isa ibn Maryam, who is preaching. So they're telling their people, we've just come from a prophet, we've just come from an individual who's come with a message after the message of Nabiullah Isa ibn Musa alayhi salam. And the reason why they mention Musa over Isa, because Isa was after Musa, and Isa was actually the prophet right after our prophet, right before our prophet. Isa was the prophet right before our prophet. Why didn't they say Isa ibn Maryam? Why did they say Musa? It's because the Prophet Musa alayhi salam's religion was the religion who Nabila Ibrahim was what? And Nabila Isa ibn Maryam was what? Explaining. The asal of the books was Torah, not Injil. Injil was was more of explanation on a Torah. So that's why they mentioned that. And Ibn Kathir mentions that. Others also have mentioned that. So that's the second. That's the second one, is that he was sent to the humans. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَةً لِلنَّاسِ بَشِيرًا وَنَذِيرًا وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. And also قوله تعالى وَإِذْ صَرَفْنَا إِلَيْكَ نَفَرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقُرْآنَ فَلَمَّا حَضَرُوهُ قَالُوا أَنصِتُوا فَلَمَّا قُضِيَ وَلَّوْا إِلَى قَوْمٍ مُنذِرِينَ قَالُوا يَا قَوْمَنَا سَمِعْنَا كِتَابًا. So when they went back to the people, that's what they said. إلى آخر الآيات. The third is الشفاعة العظمى, the supreme intercession. شفاعة العظمى is the supreme, is the, and that's the one of the day of judgment. And that's the one Allah says in the ayah, عَسَىٰ يَبْعَثَكَ رَبُّكَ مَقَامًا مَحْمُودًا. مَقَامًا مَحْمُودًا is the shafa'at al-'udhma. It's the one that's in Surah Al-Isra, ayah 79. That Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gives the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and tells him in this particular verse that he has given him مَقَامًا مَحْمُودًا. مَقَامًا مَحْمُودًا, which is what? Which is الشَّفَاعَةُ الْعُظْمَى. And that's the intercession where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam intercedes that no other Prophet can. We go to Nabi Allah Adam alayhi salam, we go to until our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When we come to him, it was for no one except him. He's the only one who can intercede alayhi salatu wa salam. That's only for him. That's a unique thing Allah gave him subhanahu wa ta'ala. The fourth, which is jawami' al-kalim, comprehensive speech. Comprehensive speech. And this is the hadith Sahih Muslim, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فُضِّلْتُ عَلَى الْأَنْبِيَاءِ, I was given virtue over all the other prophets, bisittin, six. I was given virtue to all the prophets with six things. And what did he say? I was given what? أَنَّهُ أُعْطِيَ. I was given جَوَامِعَ الْكَلِمِ, the comprehensive speech. What does it mean, comprehensive speech? Words which are قَلِيلُ الْمَبَانِي عَظِيمُ الْمَعَانِي. Words which are, its construction is very little. Its construction is very little. In other words, I say something very small, and then the meaning that are in it are very big. Like for example, the Prophet ﷺ, when the man came up to him and he asked the Prophet ﷺ, advise me, O Messenger of Allah, قل لي في الإسلام قولا لا أسأله أحدا بعدك. Say to me in Islam something I would never need to ask anybody after you. What did the Prophet say to him? قل آمنت بالله ثم استقيم. Say I believe in Allah and be steadfast upon it. That's small, but try to explain it. Try to explain, قُلْ أَمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقِيمُ. That's the whole religion. That's the whole religion. So alayhi salatu wasalam was given that ability. And he would speak, but he would speak with comprehensive speech. Like, by the way, scholars have actually written books on this. There's books that are written on it. For example, this kitab that we have, Jami' Ulum al-Hikam. What did Ibn Rajab do? He just wanted to bring the hadith, which are so small in their construction, but so powerful in their meaning. But he took it from who? Al-Imam al-Nawawi. He just added extra 8 other narrations to make it 50. But some scholars have actually come and they have added more to it. Like Sheikh Salih ibn Abdullah ibn Hamad al-Usaymi, he actually wrote a book where he brought 100 or so, if I'm not wrong, I don't remember the amount. But he also added onto it, and he came with as much as he could come with. Rather, scholars, what they've done is that to prove how the Prophet ﷺ's speech was so comprehensive, and that they themselves are principles, they're qawa'id, principles. Principles, is that they use it. In Qawa'id al-Fiqhiyah, right? They use the Prophet's speeches as a principle and a qa'idah. And the reason why Qawa'id are very what? Comprehensive. Sah? It's the ta'rif of qa'idah is that it is what? It's qadiyya kulliyya, right? That many juz'iyat and some branches come under. So the Prophet's speech was very comprehensive, that so much things will fall under. And by the way, this is the distinct thing about our religion. Our religion has put down principles that can be implemented every time and every place. You don't have to have a dalil juz'i, the evidence which is specific to this situation. You have a qa'id, a principle, not just for this situation, but rather for every situation like this that comes until the Day of Judgment. You have principles to bring it under. So that's why learning the Prophet's speech, alayhi salatu wasalam, and familiarizing yourself with the kutub al-sunnah, Bukhari, Muslim, Abi Dawood, Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, and becoming very used to it gives you that ability to become comprehensive in your speech as well. and to get to the point in issues. Naam. Last but not least is the last one, which is أن الله ختم به النبوة. Allah made him the seal of all prophets. As Allah said in the ayah, مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَا أَحَدٍ مِنْ رِجَالِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ. That he was the seal of all prophets. That's قوله تعالى, is the ayah in Surah Al-Ahzab. So Allah تبارك وتعالى here states that he is the final and the last prophet. That's the distinct characteristic of his. There's no prophet after him. There's no prophet after him. So those are five things that our messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is uniquely given over all the other prophets. The first one is that أَفَضَلُ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ, he's the best of all the prophets. The second one is بُعْثَ إِلَى الثَّقَلَيْنِ, he was sent to the jinn and he was also sent to the ins. He was sent to mankind and he was also sent to the jinn. Also الشَّفَاعَةُ الْعُظْمَى, which is that Allah تبارك وتعالى gave him the ultimate intercession, عليه الصلاة والسلام. جَوَامِعُ الْكَلِمِ, very comprehensive in his speech and the way he talks, عليه الصلاة والسلام. And last but not least is أَنَّ اللَّهَ خَتَمَ بِهِ, Allah تبارك وتعالى, he sealed him النبوة, prophecy. There's no prophet after him. There is no prophet after him. He is the final and last prophet in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent. My beloved brothers and sisters, we have finished, inshallah ta'ala, this chapter of Al-Imanu bil-Rusul, believing in the messengers, which was the fourth article of faith. We finished the fourth article of faith, what it means to believe in the messengers. We also took what are the things that nullify believing in the messengers. We also talked about khasa'is al-rusul, distinct things that messengers have. And last but not least, we spoke about khasa'is al-nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, distinct things that our messenger, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he had and Allah gave to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong, slip of a tongue, any mistakes, it's from me and shaitan, and Allah and his messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.